How does one break an SD card? I just broke my SD card. I tried to put it back in my camera, and it pretty much forced me to break it. My SD card wanted to die, and it forced me to break it. It said this shit where it's like I tried to delete all the shit off my camera, and it said I couldn't do that because my SD card is locked, which I know what that means. There's like a little switch on the side of like some SD cards that you like lock, so like nobody can like fuck with the data on it. But on mine, there like wasn't that switch. Like, there's a thing that says lock, but like the switch like isn't there really. So I tried to like push down to see if it like maybe would switch, and it didn't. And then it just ended up pulling off the whole like side of the SD card when I did that. At least I have another one though.
New man, once again. Whole new man. I think I look good. I think I look better than I did last time he cut my hair. Nothing against the last cut, I just think this one looks better. You got a whole new baseball season too, look at this.
And then I also bought my first ounce of weed today. I think this is past the legal limit that I'm allowed to have on me. So I feel like even, I think this is illegal.
Hell, that boy gave me even a little more. 28.82. And if I pour the rest of this shit in there, brings it up to 31 grams.
That'll last me probably 2 weeks.
So I'm talking to the chat GPT thing. Ab said, can you propose to your girl at a race? Yes, can you propose to your girl? Consider the timing, look, choose a location, make it special, be prepared. Overall proposal, do you do it? What if she says no and everyone sees and now it's an awkward situation? She walks away from me, leaving me in my own sorrow to sit there and watch the cars in a blank stare while I sit with the realization that my one and only love has abandoned me. Well, it's always possible that you make... it's important to remember you can still enjoy the race. If the girlfriend says no, it's okay to feel... Oh my god.
Brandon Jones doing a burnout?
Really hard.
Oh, trouble! The 25's around. That's Brett Moffitt. Oh, ooh, and the 45 almost made hard contact.
Jensen Button was just in a NASCAR race last week. And now he's back in Australia doing interviews. He's a retired F1 driver.
Oh, there we go. Car around. That's Leclerc.
I'm going to hit the blunt, real weed, and a weed pen. At the same time.
Oh, there goes Alonso! Oh, hard contact! And there goes Lance Stroll! Red flag!
Kamikaze Games just said NASCAR moment. I mean, pretty much.
I've never seen this before. This is a first ever in racing. A red flag on the final lap. This is a first. This is an awfully strange first.
Okay, so F1's literally more stupid than NASCAR now.
So they red flagged it with two laps to go, and then they obviously came back to pit road to stop the cars, and they crossed the start finish line, so now it's the final lap. But I think it's like they want to officially finish the race. They want everyone's official finishing order, because it's like you have to finish the race under your own power. So yeah, they're going to be pacing around one lap and crossing the start-finish line under yellow. And we're just waiting for that to happen. And I think, like, if you're going to do that, then just go back racing.
And Max Verstappen wins it.
Are y'all happy?
This dude just crashed, but his name is Stingray Rob. That is awesome. That is awesome. Stingray Rob, what a legend. Got up into the wall, which that wasn't the bad part. But then yeah, he goes like towards the wall. Boom. Jeez.
Oh, trouble! That's gonna be it. Joseph Newgarden wins, let's go. Oh, there goes Byron around!
Man. That's a shame after being so dominant.
I got a package. It's time to see what's in the package.
Here's the package. It's a small package,
but it's a package nonetheless. There's a lot of tape and no, there's no like clearance area to like peel the tape. Eh, shit.
I don't know what this is,
but maybe it can help me. Open. Oh, it's working. It's helping. It's like an overcomplicated scissors. That's what it seems like. Okay, what's in this? It's a NASCAR diecast. Which one? Which? Oh, it's the Cookie Crunch. Okay, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's so gorgeous. Oh God, this diecast is towards like the beginning of my diecasts, which means I have to move a bunch of them. See, okay, so I gotta move everything from this one back. That's annoying, but I'll do it. There we go. Beautiful.
D-Book! Get off the ground. Hey, KD! D-Book! DeAndre!
Oh, what's going on here? This man's all pissed. Oh, shit.
Boo!
And D-Book foul down. Bro, what the fuck? They're not even, they're doing like pace laps for a heat race. And Ty Dillon spun around. They're doing like hot laps to try to get them like more warmed up. So they are going at like faster, but like, dude, it's not even competitive laps. Look at this dude right here, Jonathan Davenport. I've literally never heard of this guy in my entire life. This is his first ever start. Apparently he's a dirt racer. Look at this, look at it. And then this man comes through. Bam! Bam! And then he gets BAM! I don't know who this is, but he looks like some guy. He's 32. He looks like the guy to be like trying to sell drugs to like a teenager. No! Trouble! There we go! Ooh! Caution! Happy Easter, everyone. I think now is a great time to remind y'all that religion is a cult. It is a cult. Never trust religion. They're always fucking out to get you. They killed millions of people over history just to be like, I'm right and you're wrong. If you believe in like Santa Claus when you're 20, or if you believe in the Easter Bunny, or if you believe in the Tooth Fairy and you're 20 years old, you're just fucking retarded. But this like magical fucking dude in the sky with a big ass beard and a fucking, his son who was a baby who died and then like came back 3 days later for your sins or some shit, that's perfectly fine. We'll just convince everyone that's true, because clearly it is. Clearly it's super true. Like, I am not smart. That's how I know that it's fake. It's because I'm a fucking idiot. I am a dumb motherfucking idiot. I have like no brain cells. I am like top tier fucking moron. And even I know, even I can see through the bullshit. Like, that's how I know.
Baseball, a plane. Plane that's gonna crash into the stadium. The stadium's now on my shit list. They've always been cool, the security, and now they're not. Why? Why now?
Look at that man. Look at that man all the way over there.
Oh my God, y'all, it's Kevin Pulecki. Hey, Kevin! Kevin, can I get a picture? I love you. I met Kevin Pulecki today. That's awesome. Kevin Pulecki, Red Sox catcher last year, then got traded. Pretty sad.
It's Scooch. Look at Scooch. He's so sexy.
Here to start with MVP next day, recognize the importance of the True-Way Cup earlier.
Kevin Pulecki. We love him.
Once again, today, the big leaguers and gentlemen, welcome to
It is Brett Beatty. Prospect. First round pick. This man just threw me up a ball. I love him. I don't even know his name, but I love him. Oh. That's, oh. Wait, that got him?
Well, the security took my vapes, but I still need something to stimulate my senses. So I gotta get food now. It's the next best thing.
Wow. Why is first base thing closed? Why am I the only one on this concourse right now? Woo! Kevin Plawecki. Brett Beatty. Very good prospect. What's the left fielder doing in the bullpen? Get out on the field, bro.
Oh my god, it's Scooch.
I love you, Scooch.
Scooch. Hey, Scooch. I love you.
This is cameraman versus cameraman, I see. Face off.
Beat it.
Jordan Weems. I followed this guy for a while because of his beautiful hair, his lovely locks. Shut the fuck up, you stupid kids. I hate kids. Jordan Weems. I love this guy. Whee! Brett Beatty. Remember when that man got drafted? Here he is. Yo, are these men good? We just collided while fucking. Get up, Kevin. Get up, Kevin. That was nasty. He's good. He's all good. Religion is a cult. God ain't real. Jews are better. Jews are better than Christians. Scientology better.
Tom Cruise is my favorite.
Y'all are probably a bunch of Jesus freaks.
Probably not if they're here on Easter.
Actually, yeah, maybe not. Well, no, because this game started at 1, so they probably went to church and then came here right afterwards.
Church, so. My Sunday best.
Here comes the closer. Not Diaz. Whoever the fuck this is. Is that really your TV camera?
Mr. Chevrolet of East Syracuse.
Come on, now.
Come on, let's throw strikes. You're up by 9. Who's in Paris?
Who's in Paris? Larson, you want to tell us who's in Paris?
Ain't it?
Kyle Larson, what was that thing you said on that live stream that one time? Oh, oh shit. That's a base hit.
Oh,
it still is a shutout. Oh, wait, no. Yeah, I forgot about him. That's 9-1 now. Syracuse Mets win it.
Fans, that'll do it from the stadium today. The final score:
9-1.
9, Rochester 1.
Bud Light made a trans ad, and everyone wants to boycott Bud Light now. I'm buying exclusively Bud Light from now on. Just
what about Corona though?
Corona, yeah. Corona and Bud Light. Woo, Bud Light, Scooch. That's my N-word right there. Hey, Scooch.
Let's go.
Fuck y'all. I'm a new stadium shit list. That's okay. I'll sneak it in next time, actually.
It's Tim Tebow and Kyle. Tim Tebow and Kyle Busch and Clint. Tim Tebow. Oh my god, he's talking about Jesus. He's talking about Jesus Christ. Y'all need some Jesus in your life. You need some Jesus for your soul. The real meaning of Easter isn't the candy or the bunny or the racing. It's about Jesus. And you need some Jesus to save your soul, my friend. Saved for your sins. You need some Jesus. He died for your sins. And he is now risen. Gina, my friend, you need some Jesus in your life. He rose today. He is back.
Joey Logano just drove into the water barrels.
Oh shit, there goes Blaney.
All right, y'all, that's where I'm gonna end this video. I wanna thank y'all for watching, and peace out, motherfuckers.